So
right.
It made you fried food.
Yeah,
like
yeah
the,
all the good
the,
fried food.
When I did yeah.
Well, so, you mentioned earlier about the Artists Entrepreneur Club. Tell us about it a little more.
So the Artists Entrepreneur Club is really, I don't want to sound, well, yes, I'm really proud of what this is, because of the people who are mm-hmm. in it. And it's a group of amazing artists, because their art practice is good, but also because they are amazing people and very supportive people. And, in the Artist Entrepreneur Club, everyone is supporting, all of the other artists in the club with business mm-hmm. advice, with feedback, sharing their experience. And in addition, I try to bring my help as well by giving business training. And I also invite, business experts in the club so they can share their own expertise with the artists in the club and we can all learn about business.
Oh, that's excellent.
This
that's
way.
Excellent.
Yeah.
You know, you may have answered this already, but I want to ask this question. You've interviewed quite a few artists. You've talked to a lot of creative people. What would be your number one suggestion uh-huh. for these artists?
For the interview, for the artists I have interviewed or for artists in
all,
general?
All artists in general, because you've been exposed to a lot of artists yeah. where you're working in the galleries.
Yes.
As well as what yes. People you've interviewed and people you've talked to on your IGTV. You've been exposed to a lot of artists and artists, for the most part, they all have different personalities. But what would you say that you've learned? What's one thing that stands out? Or the suggestion that you would have?
One thing that stands out, I'm going to answer from a business point yeah. of view, is that the thing that stands really out when I talk business with an artist is when all of the marketing and all of the things that are published and posted online are not only about themselves, but they are about the people they are trying to help. And that's, before they understand that they are, that all of this content is for the people they are trying mm-hmm. to help, is that first they have to understand that when they are selling their artworks, they're not just trying to put their artworks in somebody's house and leave, and run away. So it's not like that. You're not just leaving your artwork there. The artists are really helping people by selling them their artwork. So that's really one thing that stands out when the artists understand mm-hmm. how they help people and how it translates into their marketing and into the way they present.
I think
themselves.
That's a great answer.
That's a good answer.
That's a good answer and very insightful. And I must say, you would know because of your experience to date.
Right on.
Yeah, well, I'm glad it's helpful.
No, it is. Very helpful.
Really?
Well, my question is, what would you do to market your program and yourself as a brand if there were no social media?
I absolutely love this question because I'm actually, when I was looking for jobs in art galleries, I was really bad at applying online. Mm. And well, you could actually get a job by having a good social media presence. I have personally hired members of my team through their social media mm-hmm. accounts, so that could mm-hmm. work. But at the time, I didn't have that experience in social media, and applying online by just sending a CV and an email wasn't working mm-hmm. for me. So what I used to do is to go door to door in art galleries, and that's what I would do if there was no social media. I would definitely go talk to people and see them. And because my audience is made of artists, I would go to studio visit.
Okay,
definitely.
Sounds good.
Good answer, yeah. Gabrielle. Well, of course, there is social media. And what is your favorite thing about it?
The favorite thing about it has been, at the moment I understood that it was about creating relationships, and it was not just about showing who we are and posting things online. It's really about the connection between
yes.
people. And the first time I was told, well, when you are going to go online, you really need to build relationships. I thought, gosh, this is going to take a while because I know relationships take a while to build, but it's not true. This is not true. And if anyone is listening and thinking at the same time that, it's going to take a while to build a relationship, it goes quite fast to build strong relationships online. So that's my favorite thing about it.
And then, so what is the number one mistake people make when they're posting on social media?
Well, that would be not showing themselves. Mm-hmm. Well, sorry, I'm really repeating
myself. No, that's right. I wanted to make one comment on something you said on that last question.
Yeah.
It's been Angie's and my experience, and I suspect yours too. There's a lot of really wonderful people in this world. And it's interesting how for some, I don't know the magic behind it, but it seems like we all seem to find these kinds of people. And based on some of their posts or how they respond to your post or how genuine they are.
Yeah.
I mean, every once in a while you run into somebody who's got kind of a big ego and it's all about them.
Right.
But you know, you don't pay too much attention to those people. But the other people out there are very generous with their thoughts and their kindnesses.
Yeah, completely. It's really true that we seem to find each other, and this is why it's also very reassuring to know that, because so many people are afraid to meet bad people or to find rejection when they go online. But the truth is, only people who are your kind of people are going to react at all at what you're saying. Otherwise, they will just pass and go somewhere else. So when you are online, you are always building a bubble of people who are like you and who will like you as well. So I really agree with you, and I have been very surprised by the amazing people I have met online.